Welcome to the Jawa's Junkyard. This tutorial will show you how we're going to make our gonks. We will start with a set of legs and the gonk body with a removable top. Underneath, you'll notice that there's two holes indicating where the legs will go. The side where the holes are closest to is the side where the rear end of the gonk is. This is important for when we place our feet and the head of our gonk, or the hood of our gonk, if you will. If placed incorrectly, the hood may not fit on the gonk properly. Believe it or not, there is a left and right foot for a gonk. Don't worry about it, I will show you which one is which when we meet during our session. We will begin by painting the legs black. If you accidentally get some black paint on the foot, don't worry, just dab a little bit of water and it'll wipe off quite easily. When we're done, we're just going to leave them here aside to dry. Now comes the fun part. If you take the lid off, or the hood, you'll see that there's all kinds of gizmos, cables, and buttons on the inside. Using a gold, silver, or copper Sharpie, we're going to add detail to the little features on our gonk. There's no limit as to how much detail you can add. You can also add detail to the face on the hood of the gonk. We want the gonk to have a windswept, desert, sandy type look. This can be achieved by doing what's called dry brushing. I dip the brush just a little bit and spread the paint out on the paper, wiping back and forth until I get a chalky feeling or texture from the paint. It's kind of half dry. I then whisk gently the different areas of the gonk where I want to have the sand swept effect. Again, you decide how much of the dry brushing you wish to do to get the desired effect. Since gonks are so clumsy, they tend to bump into things and get a little bit of damage. With the silver Sharpie, we're going to go over the edges and the corners. This reveals a more damaged look, revealing metal underneath the paint when it gets scraped off. The last detail we're going to add is the effect of having oil dripping from the sides. We're going to dip a toothpick into black paint and add little drops of oil. For now, we're just going to put a little bead or a drop. We're not going to spread it around at all. We're going to add a few drops here and there. I'm going to take the dry end of my toothpick and poke the bead right in the center of the drop and drag a straight line down wherever I put some black paint. We can then take our toothpick and drag horizontally along the ledge of the gonk, or the edge of the gonk, to give sort of a horizontally leaking drip. You'll get a better idea when I show you a close-up. To finish, we will add some crazy glue to the top of the legs and place them in position onto the gonk. The glue is not dry yet, but as you can see, there's our finished product.